After 2 days of meeting behind closed doors, the breakthrough the group of rich nations was hoping for.
To ensure that there's a level playing field for all types of companies, and whether it's people operating in tax havens or it's digital companies, we're going to level the playing field and inject that principle of fairness into our global tax system. That's the prize.
The deal proposes a global minimum tax rate of 15% for the world's largest firms. It would only apply to companies with at least a 10% profit margin and would see a fifth of any profit above that reallocated and then subjected to tax in the countries they operate. The G7 singled out digital tech firms such as Facebook, Google and Amazon as a key reason for why the rules needed to change.
The argument is a simple one. As the tech giants operate all around the world, they ought to pay their fair share of tax in those locations. And it's the European countries that have led the push for these changes in recent years. And if this deal is rolled out, places like the UK, France and Germany will get to benefit from more tax income to spend on their own public services.
With all the wealthy nations here seeing their finances battered by COVID-19, those considerations are even more important. But there will be pushback. The tech giants have previously indicated the difficulties with measuring their services that are truly global. Then there are the others who stand to lose out. Nations like Ireland and Hungary, which may seem less attractive to multinational firms as a low tax base. And what about the wider world? The G7 represents almost half of global economic output, but will other countries be on board?
There are a number of countries that have concerns. Ireland and China are examples. This isn't a finished agreement. There are details still to be worked out.
Securing such an agreement won't be easy, especially with most governments still focusing on the pandemic. That was also discussed here, along with a pledge to make sure climate change is at the heart of future budgets.